averaging 32 points per game this postseason.
Talked a lot about defense and a performance like this. Yes, it was flashy offensively, but what does it leave you feeling from a defensive standpoint?
I liked our attention to detail. I like how we didn't get a lot of plays perfect, but we made the second and third efforts. And they didn't destroy us on the offensive rebound, so that showed that we were in the paint boxing out. That was an emphasis for us. But for the most part, we just did what we were supposed to do, went two at home. Now we got to see if this game is going to travel on the road for us, and we got to stay locked in.
Bruce Brown said, speaking of that, the series doesn't start until we go to Milwaukee. What do you think of that mentality?
I feel like that's every team's mentality if you got home court. We know how important game threes are, and we know that their crowd is going to be in it from the second we get on the floor for warm-ups. And we know their guys play better and more comfortable when they're in there, sleep in their own beds and got their, you know, same routines at home. So, you know, we got our work cut out for us, but we're looking forward to it.
Thanks, Kevin.
Bruce Beck with NBC New York.
Kevin, do you think your intensity is contagious because this entire team looks like they're playing with a laser focus right now?
Yeah, I mean, you got to credit that to the coaching staff. They do a good job of keeping us focused in shooting rounds and practices and not letting it slip for a second on game plan, practicing. You know, it's been that way, you know, whenever we get a chance to practice this whole season. So you got to credit the coaches for keeping us locked in. And then I try to help them out.
You know, come out of left field for everybody.
Me and Kyle talked about it once we got Bruce, that we, you know, playing against him the last 2 years. I mean, nobody really knew him in Detroit, but when you play against him and you got him in the scouting report, and he kind of disrupted our flow when I was in Golden State a bit one game. And I was like, yo, who is this kid? You know, and he was a second-round pick. I didn't hear of him. I didn't watch him in college. So we knew that he played with extreme passion and intensity. And whenever he had got a chance, early on he wasn't playing for us, but whenever he got a chance, we knew he was going to come in and make an impact.
Ryan Mahoney with the Associated Press.
Love you, bro. Love you, King. And then there was one.